Yo, what is going on? You 2 days past expiration date, Piplup. Today, taking a look at some new cards that were leaked or revealed or whatever you want to call it. So let's get right into it. First one is this Sylveon V with the Dream Gift ability. Once during your turn, you may search your deck for one item card, put it into your hand, shuffle your deck. If you use this ability though, I mean, that sounds really good, but if you use the ability, your turn ends. So not as good as it initially sounds. Search your deck for any one item card, that's great. And then your turn ends. So not quite as good as it seems, but not bad for control, which has a lot of things that you end your turn with anyways, and you're looking for very specific item cards. So I think this card could have some viability in control. 200 HP is like pretty reasonable to maybe keep yourself alive against a couple matchups or a couple decks. A lot of control decks right now already play like Zacian in them to get themselves going. So this could be another card like that that you'd play in there to find those key item cards turn to turn to potentially utilize. Now I don't play control super often at all. Not a control main, but I could see it having some viability in there for sure. You want to find your reset stamp or your chip ship ice axe or whatever you might want to find to set up your lock or your combo. Could see the Sylveon V being very good in control. Gonna have to wait and see. I don't think it's very good in anything else. Card like this, you find an item card, you end your turn, your opponent Marnie's that item card away, and then you just have a two prize Pokemon sitting on your bench that not only is its attack terrible for colorless to deal 60 damage, it's only got 200 HP. You're getting knocked out by most things. Like, definitely not worth playing in anything. Maybe decent in control. We'll have to wait and see. Let's move right along. I did want to mention the floor just real fast, that rapid connection ability. As many times as you like during your turn, you may move an energy from one of your Pokemon to another of your Rapid Strike Pokemon. So from any Pokemon to a Rapid Strike Pokemon. Could also go from a Rapid Strike Pokemon to any Pokemon, but you can't move it from any Pokemon to another Pokemon. It has to go to a Rapid Strike Pokemon. So you'd obviously have to play it with a Rapid Strike Pokemon, but it is a stage two, and the attack's not very good either, so it probably just won't see play. But I thought I would mention the ability. It's a cool ability, fairly strong overall as far as abilities go, but being a stage two, probably a little bit too much to set up to get really value out of it. The Marshadow I thought I would mention as well. It's got that rapid hunt attack for a colorless energy. Search your deck for two rapid strike cards, reveal them, put them into your hand, and shuffle your deck. Once again, probably not going to see play, just like the floor. Just it's a little bit too slow. So using your attack to just find cards for your next turn and then getting Marnied and then actually just getting knocked out means you're just kind of behind an attack, and the cards you got are probably going back to your deck anyways because of Marnie. So not very good card. But I thought I'd mention the attack is like kind of interesting. So, but overall, I don't see it seeing play. I would love it if it did. I would love to be proven wrong, but I don't see it happening. Moving right along, not too much left to talk about. But the big card, I think, the biggest card, maybe second biggest. There's another one that's coming up that's also pretty big deal. The Espeon VMAX, 310 HP. It is a VMAX, so effectively a stage one. Sun notification. As long as this Pokemon is in play, each of your Pokemon that has any energy attached to it isn't affected by effects from attacks of your opponent's Pokemon. Existing effects remain, so just evolving it doesn't remove those, but evolving it on the Eevee would remove those. Or what does it evolve from? No, it evolves from Espeon V. I was like, evolving it from an Eevee makes sense, but Espeon V to Espeon V Max. And then the attack is pretty good too. Psychic colorless, 60 damage times, this attack does 60 damage times the number of energy attached to your opponent's Pokemon. So all of your opponent's Pokemon, unless this was mistranslated and supposed to be your opponent's active Pokemon, 60 damage, this attack does 60 damage times the number of energy attached to your opponent's Pokemon. So that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Your opponent has a bunch of energy in play. Maybe it's not all in their active, but you're still doing 60 times that much damage. Now, the tough thing here with the Espeon is that energy cost, but we are going to be getting the Shadow Rider, the Calyrex Shadow Rider, that accelerates psychic energy into play. So that could be what you pair with this Espeon as kind of a Calyrex Espeon, and that could be a deck right there. So we'll see. Attack's pretty good, ability's pretty good, energy cost is pretty high, but if Calyrex is good, then maybe you just combo this with Calyrex, and that could be a deck, especially come post rotation. I think the best Calyrex deck is gonna probably be Calyrex Mewtwo, but come rotation, this might be a good partner. Both are weak to dark, so that's always something to look out for, but if dark Pokemon aren't that good, could be pretty good. But the next card we're talking about is a dark Pokemon. It is that Gengar VMAX with the Panic Fear dark. This attack does 60 damage times the number of your opponent's Pokemon V and GX in play. So that can ramp up really, really fast out of nowhere. You know, your opponent has three or four VMAXs or GX in play. You're doing 180 damage. You're basically two hit KOing anything. If they get up to like four or five of those Vs or GXs, you're one hit KOing tag teams. So off the rip, when this thing releases, it could be pretty good. Now the dark energy costs might seem a little bit much, but we are getting that Moltres here soon that accelerates the dark energy from your discard pile to itself, and then you put some energy switches in there and you can just energy switch off your Moltres to your Gengar VMAX, and you're cooking. So I could definitely see the Gengar VMAX being good. Obviously will be good against decks like Eternatus VMAX, where they have so many V Pokemon in play to function as a deck. So this could be very good against decks like that. Could be very good against stuff like Pikarom, where Pikarom only has like that 240 HP, so you only need 4 V's or GX's in play to take a 1k on that. Obviously they play Mewtwo, so that can make things a little bit trickier, but I could definitely see this card being very good. And also come rotation, I could also still see it being pretty solid overall. Pretty much has potential to 2-hit KO anything, and maybe get some big 1-hit KOs in there, possibly. But yeah, Gengar VMAX looks solid. And like I said, we have the Moltres, we have Energy Switch, so there's a way to accelerate to get to that double dark in like one turn, possibly. So look out for the Gengar VMAX. Could be good. Also could play with Mawile. Like, you want to force more Vs and GXs on your opponent's bench, put a Mawile or two in there, and then you're putting those Pokemon down on their bench. We're also going to be getting that Target Whistle, or effectively a Target Whistle card as well, to load up our opponent's bench with even more Vs and GXs. So a lot of tools for the Gengar VMAX. We'll see how good it is when it comes out, though. But I think it definitely has the potential to be pretty solid. Up next, this is maybe the best VMAX in the set. One more card that's a pretty big, that could have a pretty big impact. We got that Inteleon VMAX. That's right, another Inteleon VMAX. And this one is a Rapid Strike Pokemon. I didn't mention that. This is also Single Strike. Oh, I was talking about Moltres plus Energy Switch. We have Houndoom. Yeah, don't mind what I was saying. We have Houndoom. This is a Single Strike Pokemon. I like made note of that when I read through these initially. Then I'm coming back through and talking about them, and I completely forgot. We have Houndoom for the Gengar VMAX. We don't need... excuse me. You don't need to use the Energy Switch Moltres. You just use Houndoom, and you get more damage from the Single Strike energy. So those harder KOs are looking that much easier with the Panic Fear. Yeah, don't listen to what I was saying before. Wait, Espeon wasn't either of those, right? Yeah, Espeon's not. I was like, I'm pretty sure Espeon's not. Like, I already read through all these cards, made a note of it in my head. Didn't remember. Okay, Inteleon VMAX, Rapid Strike. Double shooter once during your turn. You may discard a water energy from your hand if you do put 2 damage counters on 2 of your opponent's benched Pokemon. That's really good. It does have to be the benched Pokemon, but we have stuff like Fiona and Escape Rope to force something out of our opponent's active to the bench to try and, you know, get KOs that way. And you're not limited to one of these a turn. So you could have 4 Inteleon VMAX set up, and you could use 4 of these abilities, putting 80 damage or 160 damage in sets of 2 on your opponent's bench Pokemon in any way you like. Now, you do need the water energy to support that. We have stuff like energy retrieval and so on. And its attack is also pretty good for water colorless, 70 plus. You may return an energy attached to this Pokemon to your hand. If you do, this attack does 70 more damage. So there's theoretically a couple ways to play this. You can play it with straight water energy plus the new water welder card. Put a water from your discard pile on one of your water Pokemon and draw 3 cards, so that would be good. You could also play it with Rapid Strike energy. It is a Rapid Strike Pokemon, so you attach the Rapid Strike energy, and then you return the Rapid Strike energy and do 140 damage. Now that means you'd have to play Rapid Strike energy, and you kind of seems like if you only have to return 1 energy from the attack, it seems like maybe just playing water energy plus the water welder would be a little bit more effective because it synergizes with your ability a little bit better. So a couple of different ways to potentially play it. I'll have to wait and see what is best. Maybe you just play like 2 Rapid Strike energy so you can just like attack, because the energy does go back to your hand, which means you don't need a ton of energy to continuously attack. If you maybe you play like 3 Rapid Strike energy, you just find one of them, put it down, attach, and kind of repeat. Then a decent amount of water energy plus like energy retrievals to keep up the snipes from the double shooter. But this Inteleon seems very good. I mean, we'll have to see how good it is once it comes out, but I'm excited to give it a shot, try it out, see how good it is, because it seems solid as well. Probably the best VMAX that we're looking at today. And then the last card we're going to look at today is Adventurer's Discovery. Search your deck for up to 3 Pokemon V. Reveal them, put them into your hand, then shuffle your deck. So this card is big. I think it'll be very good. So some of the problems with previous cards that kind of just search for Pokemon, like a Sonya or something, is... Sonya only searches for 2, which is kind of slow. But this can grab Vs, not just Pokemon V, but it can also grab V maxes. It says Pokemon V, it can also grab V maxes. So you can get, like, turn 1, you can play one of these and get, like, 2 Inteleon V and a Crobat. And then you use the Crobat, or next turn you use the Crobat, you draw into another Adventurer's Discovery, and you grab 2 V maxes plus a Crobat. And the big thing here with this one is that it goes to your hand, and unlike some stuff in the past that we've had, like Bridget and so on, it goes to your hand. So you can take a Crobat, put it in your hand, and then use that for the draw support for the turn or for the next turn or so on. And two of these back-to-back is a couple VMAXs, draw some cards with Crobat, and that's what you're going to be looking for if you played a Researcher or Marnie, but this kind of guarantees it. So, yeah, pretty good card, I think, overall. I think it'll definitely see play in some top decks that have VMAXs going or being played in them. Maybe even seeing this immediately be added to stuff like Eternatus, I could see. Who knows? Definitely a ton of potential with this card. We'll have to see how good it actually is, but I like it. I think it's a great supporter. I would love to see more supporters on this kind of same power level that at least seem this strong. It seems strong. We'll see how good it actually is. But it has all the things you want out of a Pokemon Search card right now, because if you played it, like if it was something similar to more like an Elms or a Bridget, you need draw power behind your turn as well. So this gives you the option to potentially get Crobats. And it can also find VMAXs, like only be able to find basic Pokemon when there's so many evolutions out right now. That's like another reason like something like Asanya isn't very good, because it only finds the basic Pokemon. It's like, well, I mean, it helps me set up my first turn, but am I gonna play four of these cards that I can only use one of them theoretically throughout a game, or zero if I just like draw into the basics that I need and like play a research instead. But this card can be used through many turns throughout the game. There's so many opportunities to play down this card. Turn one to get the V's initially, turn two to get the V maxes, and at any point to grab a Crobat throughout those turns or future turns can also just get a Crobat for some draw power. So a lot of potential for this card. I hope it ends up being good. And that's it. Those are all the cards I want to talk about today, guys. Have a good one. I'll see you tomorrow.